day-to-day life, do you use violence to solve your personal problems?
No.
No, right? Second question would be, with the exception of self-defense of yourself and others, mm-hmm. would you consider it wrong or immoral to initiate force?
Yeah.
And then the last question would be, would you also consider it wrong or moral to violently force your ideas?
Wait. Go ahead. I take back initiate force. Because it doesn't have to be in defense. Like, police initiate force when they're trying to stop a situation, even if it's not in defense.
Right.
Well, I guess you're saying that's immoral.
That would be immoral, right?
Okay. Yeah. Okay. I got you.
Like you having a plant, and they're trying to stop you. It's like, yeah, that's immoral. What are you doing, dude?
Okay.
There's no victim here,
okay.
Right? And that's eventually where we'll talk about that too. So the universal morals, right? Mm-hmm. So it's regardless of what color costume you have or what title you have, right? All right. So the third question would be: would you consider then wrong or immoral to violently force your ideas onto other people?
Yes.
Beautiful, perfect then. So you just tell me your day-to-day life, you have a plurality of non-violent solutions you apply and use to solve your problems.
Mm-hmm.
You have this moral integrity against that violence. And as a community of individual people here in Richmond, we're told, though, the only way we can affect any kind of change or make any difference, though, is through
government,
politics, voting, they say.
Interesting.
So people vote with their ideas, opinions, and preferences and how best to solve that community problem. Mm-hmm. And in effect, they elect a politician. That politician, his early job, then, is to legislate those ideas and opinions into law. And then those laws of opinions are then backed and enforced by the police at gunpoint.
But I kind of like government.
Well, we'll get there, we'll get there. We'll go over what is government, all that stuff, right?
Okay. I like that they do that.
Oh, all right, we'll get there. We can have rules.
Okay.
All right. All right, so then you could take government opinion, just like yesterday was a great, awesome celebration of
yes.
a plant, but government opinion that this plant is bad for everyone, and if mm-hmm. I were to smoke a plant, I'd be kidnapped, arrested, thrown into a cage,
yeah.
a prison, at which point, any point I refuse or resist because I don't agree with that government opinion and try to run away and escape, I'd be met with more violence or something, shot to murder. At the same time, government's even founded the more violence because at no point can you say, I do want to help the poor, but I don't want to fund war. You have no freedom of economic
yeah.
choice. You still have to give government your money. You still have to give up your property. You still have to pay your taxes. Because if you did have a freedom of economic choice, what mm-hmm. to do with your own money, how best to allocate your own resources, government wouldn't threaten to send you to another cage if you didn't pay your taxes, right?
Mm-hmm.
So this is how this organization called government then is immoral. Then that this organization, their only solution, the only way they know how to solve problems is through one way, though, a singular way, and that's through the threat of and use of violence to solve any problems versus the plurality of non-violent solutions that you and I already share. So what do you think
about
that?
That's really sad.
Right?
You've made me upset.
Oh,
I
no.
feel like a slave.
Oh, we are tax slaves.
Not me. I'm
oh,
not
no.
working.
Well, they tax
slide
everything.
And under.
Oh, my God.
I know.
So we're talking about what is government then, right? All that government is, very simply, they have a monopoly on the services you and I want. They have a monopoly on roads, on security, on law, post office, first class mail. It's illegal and criminal for UPS and FedEx to enter the market to deliver pieces of paper. No one's allowed to compete. Or,
right?
Or ABC. No one's allowed to
yeah.
compete against ABC to sell liquor, right? So these are government monopolies in which you don't have the economic freedom to cancel or unsubscribe as you would from a real business. Or compete entrepreneurially to say, you know what, I could provide you a better service that's not going to be abusive or harmful to you, the
mm-hmm.
consumer. That's it. That's all the government is.
Can't argue with it.
Right? Violent organization. Involves a lot of...
upsetting.
Yeah.
I know. I asked.
What other areas of government did you think... could you imagine, I guess, if we worked on a mission then... to provide these services, right? What area did you think that government was providing that you thought were... You were talking like rules, right?
Mm-hmm. Things I like about the government. Well, that's a good one. I like the roads. And I like police officers stopping people from speeding and safety laws like that. And I like certain government agencies that protect certain individuals without rights and...
Okay. Now... Do you feel, though, all these things that we're mentioning the government
mm-hmm.
provides, under, of course, have to rob you of your property in order to say we're here to protect you of your
mm-hmm.
property, can be also be provided in a free society based on consent?
Yes.
Right?
I think there are a lot of those activist organizations are already existing. I don't know. I mean, I think police could have...
What if I were to tell you many Supreme Court cases, judges,
mm-hmm.
Supreme Court rulings have said... government, police have no obligation to protect your life, liberty, or property.
Well, it's not really that's upsetting, yeah.
Right.
But it's not even like them protecting, I don't know.
Don't you want real security? If I came knocking on your door and say, hey, we'll provide security when we feel like it. It's like, well, I'm not signing that contract. Or yeah. If Netflix says, sometimes we'll stream you some videos when we feel like it. It's like, well, get the hell out of here. I'm going to Hulu, right? Mm-hmm. I'll go somewhere else. So with security, with the police then, since there's no obligation, they're not consumer driven.
There's no obligation, but that's definitely why people join, most people join the police force, is to protect and serve.
And we can have a police force in a free society. We can have a real...
But what laws would they...
Laws that you give consent to. So you can have a competition in a market of rules, right? That have respect for property rights, self-ownership.
Me personally give consent to?
Yeah, so you move in a community that says, this is a cannabis-friendly community. Mm-hmm. Awesome. If I don't like cannabis, right next door there's one that is against cannabis. That's the
but
one.
But the community then exists as a government.
Oh, no, because the difference is that government is coercive, right? A politician can tell you what you can and cannot do with your body or property, but you can't tell the politician the
but
same thing.
But politicians are supposed to be representatives.
Supposed
not...
to, but I never said okay with that rule, right?
Yeah.
So in thousands and thousands of free societies, based on consent, catering to your lifestyle and preferences, rules that you look at the pamphlet or brochure, you know, I can agree with that and the consequences. Mm-hmm. Great, I'm moving there,
okay.
Right?
Yeah,
and we can have rules and security and roads.
That's kind of like a small scale government, though. Like just picking out what things you like from different countries. You could move. You could look at a brochure and find.
You kind of see that in competition with other governments.
Yeah.
The only thing is that the people in those communities never gave consent to the government rules, though. So
yeah, that's true.
All right. So one will be expressly consensual. Government one is coercive in nature. So a lot of government has co-opted a lot of these things from in the past that used to be privatized, and mm-hmm. now we see it all in abundance all around us. And everywhere we go, it affects our lives, right? Mm-hmm. So the organization I'm with, we're talking about like activism, it's called Liberate RBA. It's a non-political organization, nothing to do with politics or politicians or anything like that. Mm-hmm. We want to create this real free society here in Richmond, outside of government,
cool.
Right? To one day hopefully grow our community large enough to just ignore it away. Because everyone here is a part of that free society community.
Do you believe that you can do this?
Yes. We have over 100 members now, parents, students, children, all kinds of people now.
Cool.
And so people of a lot of different religious backgrounds, mm-hmm. Judaism, pagans, Christians, mm-hmm. Atheists, everything. So, but together we come in harmony and we come together with this agreement with like the first three questions that I ask. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree it's wrong and immoral to initiate force. And that's universal. It doesn't matter who you are, right? If you have a title or you have a color costume that's blue or a metal piece of tin, right? Regardless of who you are. So with these principles, we can unite mm-hmm. and move forward towards a real foundational future that is founded on self-ownership, on respect, on consent.
Well, I support you.
Right? Let me give you a flyer if may find more interest. We have a party Saturday night. It's harvesting liberation. A lot of people planted tomatoes, for example, already, but like the frost, I would imagine, already killed a lot of that. But mm-hmm. now we have a second chance to plant again. So there's an awesome person that's going to do a whole great workshop on that. And that's
can't
on
make
Saturday.
It Saturday.
But we do it monthly, and you'll find our calendar events and a lot of other stuff. So I'm Cal. Huh?
Abby.
Pleasure to meet you, Abby.
Signs rule, but what about the fool?